previously on Back of the Backlog.
You're thinking about Kylo. There's nothing wrong with thinking about your friend that you haven't seen in a month, how he's doing.
He's the one that should apologize.
Dr. Mario!
Peach, when can I give you my blue
I got a game for you to show how truly sorry I am.
I'll take that as a yes. Come on, guys. I already apologized. You read the fucking letter. This shit is awkward as fuck. I can't just have you guys sit in silence. Why are you getting up? Where are you going? What are you... Oh. I wasn't expecting that.
Welcome home, Kylo. What is up, guys? It is Robert of GamingWithMe, and welcome to the fourth episode of Back at the Backlog. In this episode, we're going to be talking about the game I recently beat off my backlog, Gears of War. Gears of War is the first game in this whole Back of the Backlog series that is different. What I mean by that is that I wasn't 100% wanting to dive deeper into the game. Not that I went into the game with a negative attitude, it's just one that never quite caught my eye. However, I've owned this game since it probably released back in 2011 in this triple pack format on the Xbox 360, which came with Gears 1, Gears 2, and a Gears 2 DLC. That's apparently a part of a triple pack, is a DLC. Yeah, I guess, okay. It's a franchise that my stepdad has enjoyed a lot of, but me... Not really. I haven't really played a lot of this Gears franchise. I surprisingly played more of the multiplayer than I actually remember, but in terms of the Gears story modes, not really. Not until 8 years later can I say, hey, I finally beat Gears of War. It's funny because in 2011, I played a lot more multiplayer shooters more consistently than I do now. Every day I would pop in Call of Duty Black Ops 1 or Halo Reach. So the fact that I don't really remember playing Gears is pretty surprising. Regardless, Gears of War was released on November 7, 2006. It was developed by Epic Games and published by Microsoft Game Studios. Epic Games is now known for a small game you might have heard called Fortnite. You probably heard it. Maybe. Probably not. Gears of War is a pretty damn highly praised game with a super high 94 on Metacritic. It spawned multiple sequels, with the latest being Gears 5 that just came out this month, and spin-offs such as Gears Pop, which I don't particularly care to play, but you know, hey, it exists. Gears is a staple franchise for Xbox, but does the beginning entry hold up at all? Well, let's talk about it. As always, we're going to talk about the story first. This franchise is one of those where story is brought up pretty often, but I would probably say the later entries, because in the first Gears of War, all I know or remember is that there's these jacked dudes that are going to go and fuck up some alien-like creatures called Locusts who are also jacked up on steroids. This first one is definitely more so a game than a deep story or something, which is perfectly fine. We are introduced to Marcus Fenix, a pretty big name in the gaming world now.
Huge name. Dude is amazing.
Alright, keep it in your pants.
Kyle's a pretty big Gears fan. He's been wanting me to play this game for years. And you could tell the game has been out for years. It's about to be 13 years old. It's still a good-looking game, but when compared to its remaster on the Xbox One, it truly shows its age. When it comes to realism in graphics, 1 year you could be the most photorealistic game out there, and then a year later, a new standard is set. It happens all the time with photorealism in graphics. It's a smooth experience, pretty much locked at 30 frames per second, which is nice. As for the game itself, I gotta be honest, I didn't love it. Gears of War is split into 5 acts, each of them being a different environment, kind of. Off the top of my head, I remember a rainy place, a train, a place that kind of looks like the inside of intestines, and the outdoor areas, which all kind of, to be honest, kind of blend into one for me. Each of these areas, you'll be controlling Marcus Fenix and shooting some very muscular locusts. It's very much that blueprint of a shooter campaign. However, for the time, Gears of War did do something revolutionary. It refined the cover system and really made it popular. Other than that, if I'm being honest, I feel like it's just a normal shooter with incredibly stiff controls. Now, some may like the controls, but for me, controlling Marcus Fenix was such a chore. Just running was like absolute madness. Why does the whole screen have to shake when you're running? And why is it such a pain to go left and right? It's like you're forced to go straight. He walks slow as fuck. So a lot of times I would get stuck on some little piece of the environment, and a lot of times it actually caused me to die. And yeah, there are times where I died because I was not doing very well. But there were times where I would genuinely get stuck on something, and then like it just, because of the stiff ass controls trying to roll or run in the straight line, I'd get killed. It feels wrong. It feels like they want it to be different, to just be different, but ends up being incredibly stiff. The game is pretty much walking in a linear area and killing waves of enemies. Crouch behind some stuff, kill, and continue over and over again. There are some interesting areas that could be cool, but they end up being bogged down by the constant same enemy faces. Things that are different just isn't all that fun. There's this enemy called Berserker that you can't kill normally. You have to lead it to a door that it can run into to open until you reach a point where you can kill it with this powerful weapon that you can only use outside. The problem with this is that they use that same situation a few times within the game, so it's just another repeat. Also, the AI is pretty bad. There are times where your team members just constantly go down and they provide no help whatsoever, to the point where there are times where you'll have to restart sections because their dumbass died, and that becomes so damn frustrating. A big memorable part of the Gears franchise for people is using the Lancer, because the Lancer is not only a gun but a chainsaw. So you can get this cool animation of cutting up some of the Jack Locust. And I gotta say, I don't want to bash in the game, but I can't believe that little part is so iconic. Like, you do it once, twice, sure, but it's not worth it. You could just continue to shoot the people in a much quicker time. It doesn't give you any gameplay advantage. It's just a cool animation.
I used to own a real-life Lancer. No joke, it generally worked.
How do you know it worked?
Just trust me.
Aw, that's just fucked. Again, the game isn't necessarily bad. It's just alright. It gets incredibly repetitive so quickly, and it's not even a long game. There are still some fun parts. I quite like the Act 5 section with the whole train. But after saying 2 sentences of praise, I have to go back and talk about the incredibly disappointing final boss. You fight this boss named Ram. A taller Jack Locust with bats around him. You just shoot him. He slowly walks towards you. He gets close. You go around, cover, shoot, dead. Done in a little over a minute. I mean, do I really have to explain why that's disappointing? It's just a normal shootout with an enemy that looks like every other enemy, except he's a bit taller, he has like some more clothing on, and he says, "Die." Then there's this final cutscene where Marcus Fenix jumps from the train to a helicopter, then a sequel tease. As you can tell, I really didn't enjoy Gears of War. That's not to say as an overall package it's bad, because I obviously enjoyed multiplayer and the horde mode a lot when I was younger, but the actual campaign, eh. There are so many other better games that I could play that I just can't see myself going back to this game to play the story ever again. As for glitches, there were some minor ones where there was this one person getting chainsawed and blood was spewing out, but there was no one there. It was just happening in thin air. And there was also one where an enemy wasn't holding a gun, but other than that, it was a smooth experience. So just minor stuff. Overall, I'm going to give Gears of War a alright at best. Marcus Phoenix, more like Marcus Penis. Let me shut up, because that man is for some reason as bulky as the fucking Hulk. In fact, his penis is probably literally bigger than me, unless he's huge in muscle to cover up something small, if you know what I'm saying. Out of 10.
Marcus Phoenix's cock is not small.
Oh what, you looked it up or some shit?
I, in fact, did. Dude is hung like a champ.
Anyway, I gotta say, at how surprised I am, that I just didn't really care for Gears of War. I think if the controls weren't as sluggish, I'd probably enjoy it at least a lot more just because of that alone. But hey, I will still play Gears of War 2. It is a part of the triple pack, which means it is a part of my backlog. And you know, maybe they've improved it somewhat. And I can maybe try to see if there are any improvements to enjoy. Maybe there is more of a story that is actually, more memorable or something. I'm not sure. But you know, I'll find out one day. I think it will be a while from now. It'll be interesting to see what episode we'll be on when we play and talk about Gears of War 2. For now though, I finally beat Gears of War. I hope people understand that I'm not just trying to hate on the game. I'm genuinely just trying to talk about it. You know, I get what it did, and I get that, you know, a lot of people enjoy this franchise and this game. It just wasn't for me, and I didn't quite enjoy it. It's okay for you to like a game, and for me not to, and vice versa. You know, and that's kind of the beauty of opinions. So yeah guys, that'll be it for today. Did you like Gears of War? Let me know down in the comments below. If you can, please share this with everyone you could find on the street, because these videos take so damn long to edit and make. So yeah, I appreciate that. And if you didn't know, I make music, always in the link below. So yeah guys, I'll see you guys next time. Damn. Gears of War, I didn't really care for it, but it is officially out of the backlog.
You know, I heard your boyfriend remix.
Oh yeah? What do you think?
It was good. But I could see you were hiding what you really wanted to say.
What do you mean?
You know you just want to fucking marry Ariana Grande.
No. That's a little overboard.
Fuck a pussy.
No. I just want to collab one day. That's it. Nothing more. I missed you, man. I really did.
I miss you too.
You're an awkward fuck, you know that.
Fuck you.
Hey, what time are you guys going to sleep?
Oh shit, it's 6:03 in the morning? I guess we're talking a bit loud. Sorry, bro, I didn't realize, just catching up.
It's alright, I was just wondering.
Since you're here, Niffler, I wanted to ask you two if you heard about that Area 51 shit.
Yeah, what about it? You know, it would have been cool if they would have actually raided that shit. Imagine?
That's the thing. They did.
No, they didn't. Don't you think that would have been a huge news topic if they actually had?
Well, the government has been making sure this info hasn't gotten out. But I saw a leak where apparently an alien actually got out.
And you believe that?
I do.
I'm sorry, but I can't say I do.
I don't know.